Grace and peace. I am Sheilah Vickers, leadership architect at Savant Leadership Consulting, supporting organizations with high potential leadership and succession planning. I use my background in education, leadership, and ministry to relaunch people's lives, to leap past the limits and begin again. Today, I would like to agree with you in prayer for resources, relevance, and retention, holding on to what God has provided for forward projection. You're not relevant. Have you or your ministry or organization ever been accused of that? It doesn't give you that sunshiny feeling, does it? I mean, who wants to hear that what they have to offer isn't applicable to people's present lives? Now wait just a second before you get too consumed in that. I beg to differ with those feelings to say that you're doing what you're supposed to do when what you offer isn't applicable to people's present life. Don't get so caught up in being like the world until you become the world. It's impossible to stay relevant in the world that's changing constantly. Out with the old, in with the new. But the new grows old rather quickly. And since we have become a people fixated on new, we always need something different, something greater, something better. Could it be that people aren't hungering for the right thing to begin with? Or could it be that people don't even know what to hunger for? Could it be that the church's people are more likely fixated on the appetites of feeding goats rather than feeding sheep? I get it. You don't want to be ostracized in efforts to remove every stumbling block that could stand in the way of the lost. You may have even recalled Paul's words of becoming all things to all people, that by all means I might save some. But you see, there is a tremendous danger in our pursuit of relevance only. Since what the world thinks it needs is not always what it really needs, especially when the methods do not mirror God's methods. So what's the remedy? Well, we cannot use the shifting ideas of the culture and fickle opinions of people as our guide for life and ministry. Instead, we must emulate Jesus in thought, word, and deed. We're not called to reflect the culture. We are called to transform it. We cannot be effectively relevant the Christ way until there is retention. The Hebrew word is kazak, which means to hold fast and to strengthen what you believe. Hebrews 2:1 advises this. Therefore, we ought to give the more earnest heed to the things which we have heard, lest at any time we let them slip. So in a world where it's so easy to place emphasis in the wrong places, be careful not to put relevance before obedience to God. In the words of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. in his letter from a Birmingham jail, he says, the church was not merely a thermometer that recorded the ideas and principles of popular opinion. It was a thermostat that transformed the mores of society. It is then when he gives us the God ideas, witty inventions, and consequently, then the resources will come for which we ask. They will flow because we trust and obey God. So let's pray right now. Father, we thank you for being in this place, and we thank you for calling us to where we are so that we may come to where you are. You said that the steps of a good man are ordered by you. So God, we thank you for guiding our steps even now. Thank you for leading us to you, the author and finisher of our faith. Thank you for being the one that we can come to about any and everything. When networks and organizations and knowledge and resources and people fail, God, we thank you for being the God that never fails. You never sleep and you never slumber. Thank you for being concerned about us. And thank you for being a prayer answering God. Lord, we place ourselves in position to see you and to hear you clearly concerning our lives, our gifts and our callings and our purpose. Lord, we ask that you give us strategies now in the Holy Spirit to maximize our gifts. Help us to reach our full potential concerning our God-given gifts. So Lord, our talents are naturally and innately given by you, but God, our gifts is what draws others to you. So Lord, we give our gifts and ourselves back to you today. Jesus, some of us have been tempted to allow our gifts to grow stagnant and become at a plateau. Some of us have gotten comfortable in how we are used until it has become almost rote and predictable. But God, wake us and shake us again to realize that we are nothing without you. We are absolutely nothing without you, Lord. Bring back to our spirits that you gave us the gift and that we should use it well for your glory. God, put a fire under us to be motivated to fine-tune our gifts. Some of us have become lazy and satisfied with mediocrity, but I rebuke the spirit of complacency right now in the mighty name of Jesus. God, help us to strengthen our gifts with time and prayer and study. Stir us to grow, not to depend on our flesh to get things done. Help us to lean and depend on the anointing. Help us to serve you in excellence. Yes, Lord. Lord, so we open up ourselves up to you. We reach for those untapped areas in us. Lord, the untapped areas of giftings that we have never been used in. And God, hallelujah, we are standing and waiting on you to use us. God, use us in ways that are beyond our experiences. God, use our gifts to see you, to that we may reach others for you in ways unimagined, in ways that are beyond what our human faculties can even provide. Help us to tap in to the supernatural power of your glory. Even now, I hear you calling our spirits and command us to come up higher, come higher. We hear you calling us to meet you in that higher place. We hear you calling us to meet you in the realm of glory. Get a glimpse of where we're supposed to be to operate in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. I feel your undeniable supernatural presence of your glory. So God, help us strive to meet you there where our gifts can be in operation. Lord Jesus, hallelujah. God, we rebuke the spirits of competition and comparison in the name of the Lord Jesus. Help us not to compare that which you gave us to anyone else. Help us to seek you. Help us to seek to please you. We rebuke the haughty and the lofty spirit. Help us to display humility in all that we do. Help us to be humble so that even when our leaders bring us to correction, that we are not so defensive, but we're able to receive instructions that will aid our growth. We rebuke the spirit of procrastination. Lord, let us hear you clearly when you call us and let us be quick to answer that call. Help us to obey without delay, Lord. Help us to know that maximizing our gifts only builds us, but building your kingdom is where you want us. And as we use our gifts, the kingdom is being established even now. Help us to impact this dying world for the risen Savior. So God, we thank you in advance for the mighty exploits we shall do in your name. We thank you for the bodies being healed. We thank you for the spirits being lifted. We thank you for the ways being made. We thank you for the deliverances taking place. We thank you for families being restored. We thank you for saving the lost and reclaiming the backslider. We thank you for the explosion of the Holy Ghost sweeping the nation through prayer. We thank you for an end time revival hitting every street, every corner, every home, every school, every office building, every family, every person's body, every mind, every heart. We send a charge of the anointing through this platform and we beat back the flies of the enemy off from our anointing. God, belly wash us so that we will freely give you a yes, Lord. And we say, yes, Lord, we count it done and we decree it is so. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.